So my goal for today, I only have 5 minutes, so I'm going to be very quick, is to actually explain why we're here. Why are we part of the Presto Foundation? So first of all, a little bit about me. I'm Justin Borgman, founder and CEO of Starburst. Prior to Starburst, I was a VP and GM at Teradata, and prior to that, founder and CEO of a SQL and Hadoop company called Hadap back in 2010. I've been a member of the Presto community since roughly 2014 when we first started collaborating while I was at Teradata. So it is great to be with you all, some familiar faces, some new faces as well. Who are we? Who is Starburst? Well, we employ the creators of the Presto project along with many of the leading contributors from back then. That has now since changed to Trino, and I'll briefly mention that. But obviously it was Eric, Martine, Dane, and David who had this idea of creating a fast query engine that would allow you to access data anywhere back in 2012. And this is an oldie but goodie, but a photo I think from back around 2012. Starburst, the company, was founded later in 2017, originally as a bootstrap business, profitable around Presto. So back in 2017, there was only Presto, and we were offering support and services to early users, early adopters of that technology. Since then, we've grown tremendously. Today, we have over 150 customers. We've raised $164 million, most recently from Andreessen Horowitz as the business has grown. A brief history. Some of you know this, some of you don't. I've heard Trino mentioned earlier today, and I thought it might be useful to kind of explain how we got here. So obviously Presto was created in 2012 by Martine, Dane, David, and Eric. It was then open sourced. And then Teradata, while I was at Teradata, established the first commercial offering supporting the Presto project. That's how I first got involved in that community working with Facebook back in 2014. In 2017, we started Starburst, again, behind the PrestoDB project. In late 2018, end of 2018, Martine, Dane, and David decided to leave Facebook and continue development on a separate path. And that was initially called Presto SQL, and they established their own foundation called the Presto Software Foundation in early 2019. Of course, then Facebook contributed the trademark to the Linux Foundation, and now the Presto Foundation was born somewhere in the later half of 2019. Up to this point, Starburst was continuing to develop along Presto SQL and supporting efforts on Presto SQL, and was trying to work with the Linux Foundation to bring these communities back together. Once we realized that that likely wasn't going to happen because things had diverged too much, we still wanted to be part of this foundation, and we're going to talk about why in a moment. But Presto SQL was then rebranded to Trino. So again, there was a split at the end of 2018. You had Presto SQL and Presto DB. Presto SQL became Trino. So if anyone's wondering what the heck is Trino, what the heck happened, that's the story behind how we got here. Now, if Starburst is built off of Trino, then why is Starburst even here? And I think that's the question on people's minds. Well, the projects have diverged since that period of time. There's been substantial efforts on both sides in different architectural directions. And you've heard some of those elements today about things that PrestoDB is working on, both in terms of ARIA, rewriting some pieces in C++, the Raptor X project, and so forth. Similarly, Trino has developed a lot of different features that don't exist in PrestoDB either. And I think for the end customer, you just want to be able to move potentially from one to the other and be able to have, you know, the best of both worlds. And so our goal in being here is to help encourage compatibility and establish conformance program and work with the Linux Foundation and the Presto Foundation to do that so that there are common APIs and common interfaces that would allow you to pick and choose as you see fit. Ultimately, we think that is in the best interests of the end users in the community. So that's why we're here today. I want to thank you very much for your time. Appreciate being here, and hopefully look forward to seeing many of you in person at the next one. So take care.